Hi, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is the first episode to create an e-commerce website using WooCommerce. WooCommerce is a popular e-commerce plugin for WordPress. It was launched in September 2011 but became more popular because of its simplicity and easy to use. Before installing WooCommerce, we need to install WordPress. So today, I will show you how to download and install WordPress in localhost using XAMPP. We'll then copy one of the themes so that we can customize and add Google font and font awesome. By the end of this course, we'll complete building this simple fashion website. In the homepage, you can see we got header, hero, newly arrived products, some categories, sale products, brand and footer. Then we have a separate shop page where we can see a list of different products. Then we got FAQ page with some questions and answers. Blog page with some posts and comments. Contact page with contact form, and finally my account page where we can log in and register as a new user. If you are interested to see a demo of this website at your end, or if you want to download this project from my GitHub account, then feel free to check the link in the description below. Now let's get started by downloading WordPress. So open the new tab and you can type download WordPress. You can then open the first link, click on this download WordPress button, then you can open this downloads folder. Now extract this zip file. And then you can rename it to eFashion because that will be our project name. Now copy this folder and paste it inside this XAMPP folder and sdocs. Now go back to this XAMPP folder again and click on XAMPP control. This is to make sure that Apache and MySQL are running. Currently in my case they both are running, so you can go back to the browser, open new tab, and let's create a database using localhost/phpMyAdmin. Then click on this database. Then over here you can write new database name. So I will write eFashion2 because you can see eFashion is already being used. Once ready, you can click on this create button and then you should see eFashion2 as our new database name. Now since we got the WordPress folder and a new database for our project, we can now install WordPress. So open new tab and then you can type localhost/eFashion. eFashion because it is our project name. You can just confirm over here it says eFashion, then press enter key. Click on let's go, then for the database name we can write eFashion2 because eFashion2 is our database name. Then for username always choose root, and for password always keep it blank. Then you can leave rest of the information as it is. Click submit, then click run the installation. Then here you can write this site title name. I will call it eFashion. Then you have to choose one username to log into the admin panel, so I will just choose admin for the time being, and choose password. I will choose weak password admin for the time being, but if you are using for the real project, then make sure you choose the strong password. Then I will just add my email address and then click on install WordPress. Success. It means WordPress is successfully installed on your localhost. Now if you want to log in to the admin panel, then you can just click on this login button, then choose the username which is admin, and choose the password that is admin as well, and click on login. So this is the admin or backend of WordPress. If you want to look at the front end, then you can hover on this eFashion and then you can click on this widget site. I will just open them in the new tab, and this is how the front end looks like at the moment. If you want to change this front end or theme of this site, then you can go to the admin panel, go to appearance and click on themes. Then currently we have three different themes: 2020, 2019 and 2017. If you want to activate any of this theme, then all you have to do is hover on them and then click on activate. Now if you refresh the site, you should see a different theme or layout. Now for this tutorial, I want to use 2020 theme and customize them. So you can open your project folder and click on WP content, themes, and copy 2020 folder, and then you can rename it to eFashion. Now to use this theme, you can go back to your admin panel again and refresh the site. And now you should see one more theme called eFashion. So click on activate. Now if you refresh the site, you're gonna get the same look and feel of 2020 theme, which is absolutely fine, because in the upcoming session I'm gonna slowly modify this theme. But for now, if you are interested to change this theme detail, then you can open style.css. And then you can update this information. For example, I want my theme name to be eFashion, and then I don't want this information, so I'll just remove it. I'm happy with this one. Then I want to change the description to "this is my custom WooCommerce theme." Then in the author I want to write my name. Then I want to remove all these URLs, and then keep everything as it is. Now if you go back to the site and refresh them, you should see everything is changed now. The theme name is eFashion, and the author name is my own name and my description. Then if you want to change this theme image, then you have to crop the image and then rename it to screenshot.png. You can then copy this image and paste it inside this theme folder. You can replace the file. Now if you refresh the admin panel again, then you should see the theme image. Let's do some hard refresh, and then you can see the theme image has been changed to our e-fashion now. You can click on them and you can see all the information has been changed according to our theme. Finally, let's add Google Font and Font Awesome 5 CDN link. So open your header.php. And just before the end of this head tag, you can paste Google and Font Awesome 5 CDN link. Since this is a WordPress tutorial, I want to copy CSS from the project itself. Now you can refresh the site again and then you should see some style changes because of my CSS. Great. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we will install WooCommerce plugin, create some pages and work on main navigation. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel to get more tutorials in the future. Thank you.